Hello and welcome to a new video. I'm going to be doing a book haul today. I'm filming this on January 3rd, but I'm not sure when this will be going up. But I have some gift cards from Christmas that I spent on some new books. These are all historical romance. That's just what I'm in the mood to read, so it's what I'm in the mood to buy. I am very excited to get into it. This is going to be a quicker video because my camera's gonna die. First at Barnes & Noble, I got A Lady's Guide to Mischief and Mayhem by Amanda Collins. I read How to Dance with the Duke by Amanda Collins this year, back in 2020, and absolutely loved it. It's one of my favorite books of that year, so I bought this new release from her. It is about Lady Catherine and, what is his name, Andrew Eversham, and they are solving a mystery in 1865, and I am just so interested in this. I bet it's gonna be so good. I love how she writes mystery, and I loved her character, so I cannot wait to pick this up. Next, the rest of the books are from Half Priced Books. I had a gift card there as well, and I got mostly from the clearance rack, but I got a couple others as well, all historical romance. First, I have The Virgin and the Rogue by Sophie Jordan. I don't remember whose channel I saw this on, but I saw someone read it and they really, really loved it. I want to say it was Crystal Bookish Life, but I can't remember. But it looks really good. I think it'll be a really fun book to read. It is the first in the series. It's about Charlotte and Kingston. So it's about Catherine, who is betrothed to someone else, but somehow she ends up in a more compromising position with Kingston, who I believe is like a rake. I don't really know how she ends up with that with him, but she finds herself incredibly attracted to him, and that's how their story begins. I think there's like maybe a love potion involved. I don't know. I just remember hearing someone really, really loved it, so I want to give it a try. Next is The Taming of a Scottish Princess by Karen Hawkins, and this step back is just so gorgeous. I love it. It is about a story. I'm gonna be honest, I didn't read the whole back of this. I literally just saw the word famed Egyptologist and I was sold, because that's what How to Dance with the Duke was about, and I really, really loved it. But in this one, he is the Egyptologist, not the heroine. And they are traveling to some remote island, and he's bringing his assistant, Miss Jane Smythe, and they sort of fall in love on this journey. So I'm very excited for that like sciency aspect of it, or like history academic type thing aspect to it. I'm very excited to give this a try. Next, I picked up The Duke is But a Dream by Anna Bennett. I found this in the clearance section and just thought it sounded really good. It's about Miss Lily Hartley, who writes an advice column for women and gives like sort of almost like taboo advice for women in the historical times. And the hero is Eric Nash, Duke of Stonebridge, and he finds this girl disguised as a boy, and it is Lily because she has to pretend to be a boy to turn in her advice column and write under a male's pseudonym, and she falls and hits her head and forgets who she is, and he tries to help her figure that out. I haven't read an amnesia story. I don't know if that's something I liked, but I just thought the fact that she dressed up as a boy to write this advice column was such an interesting idea, so I do want to give this a try. Plus, this one is really short. It's only 300 pages. Next, I got The Wallflower Wager by Tessa Dare. Let's look at this step back. It's gorgeous. Not my absolute favorite, but I really do like the bottles in this one. I am very excited to give this a try because everyone has said they really loved it. I don't know a whole lot about it's about. All I know is that she lives in this big home and has all these animals, and then he moves in next door and wants her to like get rid of them or something because they're annoying to him. I don't really know. But I have read A Tessa Dare and I did really enjoy it, so I'm excited to give another one of her books a try. Then I picked up When a Scot Loves a Lady by Catherine Ash. I thought this one looked really interesting, one because it's a Highlander romance and I want to try more of those. And I thought it's interesting that he is an agent of the Secret Falcon Club. I don't know what that is, but it sounded fun. And she somehow gets involved in it, and I believe it is a Christmas slash holiday novel because she said she never wanted to spend her holidays in a wretched country village in Scotland, and I just thought it would be a fun little read, a Highlander novel, and I was just intrigued by what this secret club was. Next, I got Forever Your Earl by Eva Leigh. Eva Leigh, I don't know how to say her name. I loved Fake Your Rake by her, so I picked up. This is the first in this series, I am pretty sure, and it sounds really interesting. It is about Eleanor Hawk, and she writes a gossip column, and she loves all the scandals and talking about that, gambling hells, masquerades, all that stuff. And then Daniel is the hero, and he never expected to fall in love with this sharp-minded woman, and somehow they meet. I don't really know how, but it looked really good. I was just intrigued by the gossip column thing. That just sounds like such a fun character to read from. Next, I picked up Cold Hearted Rake by Lisa Kleypas. I really like this step back. I mean, that pink dress is to die for. I am pretty sure this is the first in this series, if I am not mistaken, and I really wanted to try more books by Lisa Kleypas. I've read one, and I would really like to read more because I think she's an incredible writer, and this just looked like a really fun book to try. I didn't even read what it was about. So Devin is a rake, as evidenced by the title, and he doesn't want to get married, he doesn't want to have any responsibility, but Kathleen comes into the picture and she doesn't want to like him, but she does, and so it is about them trying to find balance between each other. I don't know exactly how they come to meet, but I think this will be really good, and I've heard really good things about this book and this whole series by her. Lastly, I have When Beauty Tames the Beast by Eloisa James, and this step back literally is also to die for because maybe I'm just a sucker for a pink dress, which is true. So this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling, and I really wanted to try some Eloisa James books because I follow her on Instagram, and she just seems so smart and intelligent and so nice, and from what I've heard, she writes really good books, so I'm excited to try this. I'm also always up for a Beauty and the Beast retelling. It's probably my favorite, like, fairy tale to be based off of, and this looks really interesting. This is about Piers, Earl of Marchant. He lives in a castle in Wales. I didn't even see that. That's really cool. Not a lot of books, I think, take place in Wales. So it's rumored that he has a wound that has left the Earl immune to the charms of women. And he has a bad temper. He kind of lives over by himself, like the Beast. But Lynette is not just any woman. She is more than mere lovely. Her wit and charm brought a prince to his knees. So she estimates the Earl will fall madly in love in just 2 weeks. She somehow makes her way to his castle or his house or whatever, and it's a Beauty and the Beast retelling where they fall in love. So I'm very excited. I am in such a historical romance mood when I'm filming this, so I'm very excited for all of these, and I got really good deals. So I had gift cards, but I got all these for $28, like I said, and I am so excited to be trying more of them. There are so many books I want to read in 2021, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you have bought any books recently, or if you're being good and trying to not buy anything right now. Once I'm done with my gift cards, I think I will not buy too much, but we'll see, because that clearance section at Half Price Books really gets me. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!